5/20/21, we have the SPY, SPY. Yes, we do. It came down and it tested that 50-day moving average as it did. Then it gaps up and it gets above the 10, and there is the 20, and here is where we have that small gap down in the SPY. Okay, now what I can say is that we're moving closer and closer to what we call a daily buy signal, and that's everything that we want to see, which is bodes well for the S&P. We start with the gap, and we're going to see if we can take out this major trend line. It's going to be where we gap down right here, and we're going to see if we come back and make those highs. That's exactly what we're going to look at. Now, when we look at the SPY on a monthly, which we, I mean a weekly, which we like, but we could take a look at it on a monthly level. And we're approaching, like I said, it's been on fire for a long time. And we've had that little dip there on the monthly. And it still has a monthly buy signal. And the weekly chart is above the 10-week dip below it, just like it did here. Now, this is where that trend had started to these all-time highs up here on the SPY. So, if we dip down with the market and we hold support level down in here, then we are buyers here no matter what on top of that moving average. If we slightly dip as we do below that key 10-day simple moving average is what this is. So, we're teeter-tottering with it. It had a $5.76 move to it, so it ended up positive 1.08. We always look at the SPY because that gives us an idea. Of course, it tracks the S&P 500 as it does, and the S&P 500 ended up very nicely today. Ended up 42.86, and it did. And the SPY had the move that goes right along with it. So once again, keep your eyes on the SPY, buy the dips on the pullback. They're nice little traders. Use the options. Sign up for the free trial. We'll give you the alerts. Oh yes, we will. Not only that, you'll enjoy that relationship because it's great. Just sign up. Click on the link.